and two old members of the group, Richard Barbieri and Steve Jansen, who now make up the Dolphin Brothers, are my guests on today's show. I was thinking, you know, David Sylvian has almost shunned the mainstream and very much gone his own way. It's something I know that you've partly done while you've been putting this group together, but ultimately, I suppose you do have to sell records to survive in the marketplace. How do you sort of square the two different ideas, really, Steve?
Well, we've never been very good at that, actually. We just trust in our own instincts. We don't follow any patterns. We don't jump in any bandwagons. That's our approach. It's always been like that as a band, and the two of us now. It's not designed. It's not premeditated. We just have to hope that people like it, and that's the most we can do.
Japan, the country, still seems very important to you as a duo. You've toured there quite frequently, as I understand it. You have a Japanese engineer who's been working quite closely with you. What is it about the place that still seems to appeal?
I guess we have a lot of good memories from that country, as we did a lot of work there. Also, things seem to go very well when you're over there. It's easy to get work done. It's easy to put projects into action. So whenever we think about it, we have a positive view of that country, just because everything works so well there. Of course, the culture is very interesting as well, so there's a lot to learn about the country. Mm.
You seem quite anxious too, Steve, to draw influences from a lot of different places outside of Japan too, don't you?
Yeah, our musical influences have always been quite diverse, and we look at things from different standpoints. We follow no rules musically. The more we break, the better. I mean, it makes it more interesting. We absorb most music.
As sort of individuals from Japan, you've also seemed to be very aware of the visual side of music too. And I know you've written some ambient music for films and so on. Is that still very important to you?
We do enjoy that a lot. I mean, to us, that's a much better way. I mean, putting visuals to music is virtually impossible, but actually, soundtracks are one of the most interesting areas to work in, music. Because you're actually creating an atmosphere from what you see visually, audibly. It's great.
So how have you translated that into the video for your new single?
I wanted to tell you about that.
Okay,
I think the video is a combination of things that we didn't like about videos. We tried to, there were so many things that we find difficult to relate to in making a video, and we tried to stay away from those. And we gave up control to a certain extent because we were working with a director whose work we liked before, and we decided to let him put forward an idea. And it just followed through, and it's a bit conceptual, it's a bit odd. We find it difficult to live with videos.
We've always had a difficulty with videos because it's so difficult to sum up your music visually in like 3-4 minutes. It's almost an insult, and it takes away the imagination of the listener. But anyway, it's part of making records.
But also, if it's done well, I always think, like, if a good movie doesn't always spoil a good book, I think you can probably create something worthwhile. But anyway, let's see what the audience think of this. Thanks very much for coming in, and no doubt more material to follow.
Sure.
Good. Well, thanks very much, guys.
Thank you.
Okay, here we go then, the Dolphin Brothers, and this is their new single and video, dare I say it, Shining.